Now, a warning for parents about a game with deadly, dangerous consequences.
11-year-old son Drew Fiala didn't die from illness or a car accident. He was trying something called the choking game.
Don't know what it is? Neither did Drew's parents, but he and his friends certainly did. And now Drew is dead.
This house is a lot quieter lately.
He always knew he was there. He made his presence known.
So is the football field, the wrestling mat, the soccer field.
He didn't hold back. I mean, he enjoyed doing everything.
Drew Fiala was an ornery, loving 11-year-old, Luke and Candy Fiala's little boy.
From the time he was born, we knew that there was something special about him.
Friday, March 12th, Drew was nowhere to be found.
For 3 hours, we looked for him and looked for him and looked for him. The whole town was looking for him. I'm sitting here the whole time and I'm running around town just seeing if he's walking down the street, coming home from a buddy's house, and he was upstairs the whole time in his room.
Drew had a belt around his neck. He'd suffocated. Investigators say he died as a result of the choking game.
I don't even know how to explain it. I mean, getting hit in the gut is even anywhere comparable of how I felt.
Luke Fiala had never heard of the choking game. Candy heard of it as a kid, but never is something done alone.
I think I was an experiment. I really do. I think he found out about it through his friends, and he wanted to experiment.
Word of what happened to Drew quickly spread in his hometown of David City. And as people started talking, the sheriff started asking, how many kids are doing this?
If you got one kid doing it, you'd be foolish to think that that's the only one that's heard about it, thought about it, tried it.
A quick internet search and hundreds of videos pop up. Kids and teens making themselves pass out for the rush of coming to. Sheriff Mark Hecker says after talking to kids, he knows this is in their community, and it's a concern.
I absolutely hate the fainting game title or the choking game title because you hear that, and for kids, they go, oh, it's a game. It's not a game. It's really a life-death situation here. There's no game to it.
I got a beautiful set of chimes outside that when the wind blows, I get to hear them.
Drew was buried on what would have been his 12th birthday.
We need this to stop. We don't want any more of these deaths that should never, ever happen. I would have never thought this, never. There was just too many things in Drew's life that we wanted to do or he wanted to do. You know, just too many things.
Now, Nebraska Health and Human Services doesn't track choking game stats, but the Centers for Disease Control does.
And a study published in 2008 showed 82 deaths from 1995 to 2007. Butler County is hosting a forum this Tuesday night to talk about what happened to Drew and to share information about the choking game with parents and families. It's at David City Aquinas School, and that starts at 7 o'clock.
And the Butler County Sheriff also wants you to watch out for these warning signs: sudden bruises or marks around your child's neck, ropes, belts, or other things seemingly showing up without reason in your child's possession. If your child starts spending more time alone behind closed doors, also, check your computer. Look for websites or searches about the choking game.